I asked the kids, what would happen if somebody dropped sugar in my coffee? They said, well, you'd be okay. I said, what if somebody dropped strychnine in my coffee? They said, well, you'd be dead. I said, correct. Lesson one, life is both sugar and strychnine. You gotta be careful. I said, what if my worst enemy drops in the sugar? They said, will you be okay? I said, what if my best friend, even by accident, drops in the strychnine? They said, well, you'd be dead. I said, correct. Lesson two, watch your coffee.
And by the time here in Central Park waiting for the red lights, I would just ask you this question. Who's watching your coffee? Just watch your coffee. So be careful who gives you advice. Sometimes our beloved people and very close family members and even our best friends sometimes can put poison in our coffee. And these are usually the naysayers. Sometimes they do it for no reason. Sometimes they do it just because they are confused. Sometimes they love too much. They love us too much, or they love you too much. And sometimes they give you best advice, which is supposed to be very good, but in fact is not so good. So my suggestion here is be careful who give you advice. Your enemy or your best friend sometimes can give you the worst advices. It doesn't matter who will put poison in your coffee. And we're right here at, again, Bethesda Terrace. Here to give you this message, so just be careful to give you the best advice, and sometimes the best advice always come from within. So here is the time for you to be critical, and here is the time for you to ask the questions. Is that a good investment in myself, attending a seminar? Is it something that I will benefit? Is it something that I will learn? And I want to say here, because most of the people will be the naysayers. That's not good for me. It's too much time to waste. It's too expensive. That's bullshit. I don't know this guy. And all these excuses in your mind. But I want to mention this. You and only you are your best advisor. So ask yourself the question. What a seminar can do for you? What can you really get out of it? What is it about? Even if you get only one or two or a few good ideas, I guarantee you that there will be at least 20 good ideas that will improve your performance. But the question is it worth only if you get one or two ideas? Is it worth the money? Is it worth your time? So that's it.